everyone, and welcome to another episode of the UPS Small Business Spotlight Series. My name is Ramon Ray, founder of Smart Hustle Media at smarthustle.com. And I am so excited to moderate this conversation between Crystal Lassiter, Senior Director of Global Sustainability at UPS, and two of the co-founders of Nimble, Kevin Malinowski and Ross Howe. First with you, Ross, can you tell us a bit about Nimble and how you got started?
We started Nimble in 2018. Kevin and I both worked together actually within the consumer technology industry for probably multiple decades between the two of us. And what we realized was that there was no really mission-driven company within consumer tech. That is, there was no company really addressing sustainability in a real way. So okay. We looked around the industry. We said, who's talking about the environment in a real way? Who's talking about their workers in a real way? Who's leading with transparency? And it really seemed like there was a gap. And that's where Nimble came in. We started in early 2018, launched our first products that year, really with the goal of creating products in a better way. That's using sustainable materials, plastic-free packaging, carbon-neutral shipping, holding all of our suppliers to a really high standard across the board when it came to workers' rights.
So Kevin, listen, you left the corporate world. The corporate world you left, I'm assuming safe and secure, well-paid. You left it to start Nimble and join Ross. Tell us about that experience. Why'd you do that and how'd that work out?
Yeah, I mean, we came from the consumer electronics industry. So we had a really good understanding of the challenges that the industry was facing when it came to sustainability. I mean, Ross and I would, for years, walk around the CES floor, which is the largest consumer electronics show in the world. And we'd be looking for, you know, who was stepping up to address this. And we realized, you know, after a few years that it really wasn't happening. Very little attention was being paid to sustainability outside of maybe, you know, energy efficiencies. But two of the biggest areas that actually weren't being addressed that we felt were that needed to be addressed was the overwhelming amount of plastic packaging being used in products. And then the end of life of these products. So, you know, the increasing e-waste issue that our industry was creating.
Yeah, I think it's horrible.
Yeah. So we basically sat back and said, okay, how do we address this in addition to creating products that are themselves made with better materials? And, you know, we came up with Nimble. And that was really the purpose, was to show how the industry can address this and just do everything in a better way.
Yeah, and Crystal, I just want to throw one thing to you. You lead a lot of UPS's sustainable efforts and et cetera. And I think, you know, many of us know CES, all these tech companies, but it must warm your heart, as it were, to see companies not just selling tech, not just getting into the tech and our consumer, but being sustainable. Am I correct? That must be something that causes you and UPS as a company to feel good.
Definitely. And even sitting here and listening to Kevin and talk about the concern about, you know, not just being a company, but one that's sustainable, yeah, it really does make my heart glad. And I'll say that we have truly seen an increase in general in interest from not only our companies, but even our investors and our internal stakeholders. And, you know, we've seen that increase in sustainability. More customers like Nimble, you know, really are interested in working with a company that is also sustainable. And as a logistics company, we definitely impact the emissions and other companies or small, medium businesses' overall emission numbers. So we understand that we have a responsibility, yeah, to not only, you know, give our customers, our small, medium businesses, solutions to help optimize their business, but we also have a responsibility to operate sustainable.
Carbon neutral, I know, is so important. We heard Ross and Kevin talking about it with Nimble. Crystal, why is that so important to UPS? And in fact, what is UPS doing to reduce the carbon footprint of the world?
Yeah, so I think it's important, as Ross and Kevin mentioned, you know, companies are setting their own bold sustainability goals or targets. And a part of that is reducing emissions. And so as a logistics shipper, we understand that we have a responsibility to do our part to help our customers reduce their shipping emissions. So one thing that we do offer is a carbon neutral offering. And with that, UPS provides a way for our customers to reduce their environmental impact of shipping with our carbon neutral program.
And so I'm guessing that, so you've seen a massive increase, and I'm curious, Ross, I want to come to you about why that is. Why have you got this increase? I mean, is it that because people are at home more and things are shifting that I guess the purchase of consumer electronics has not diminished, but maybe has increased? And so that's question one. And then what are you doing to meet that? Because nobody knew it was going to happen. Nobody expected it. So one, why do you think that increase is happening? Ross, I'll turn to you. And then second, what are you doing? So first, why is it happening?
I think a lot of it is to Kevin's point, you know, people are looking to make an impact with every dollar that they spend. They are, you know, they are seeing the world as a smaller place. You know, you see it across the board. There's beauty brands, there's fashion brands, there's food brands. They're all talking about, you know, doing business in a better way. You know, that's really what we're trying to do with technology. You know, people look at our products, they see that we're using recycled plastics, recycled aluminum, we're using hemp, we're, you know, plastic-free shipping. We talk about that we're carbon neutral. So I think that we're getting a lot of attention. Our business is increasing, especially online, because people have, you know, all the options in the world when they're looking at, you know, all these online marketplaces, they're looking on, you know, search engines, and they come across Nimble and they're like, why would I not, for the same dollars, buy a product that has less impact on the environment and is actually giving back to nonprofits to help do business in a better way.
And just to rip off that too, I think people are actually looking for something more than just a product that's reasonably priced, that does its job, that's maybe aesthetically pleasing. I mean, people really dive into who we are as a brand because they want to know what this mission-driven type of company is all about, especially in a space that's not really had a mission-driven company, right? So for us, that really just means, you know, building great products, but really considering and all the decisions that we make, considering our customers, considering our employees, first and foremost, considering our communities, and then of course the environment. And that really encapsulates, you know, our vision as a brand and how we want to do business.
Crystal, are you seeing any difference in interest or increase in maybe what you'd have experienced 5 years, 10 years, whatever the number you and your team, you know, what UPS is doing? Have you seen a shift in like your phone, as it were, off the chain for your division dealing with sustainability? Has that changed? And why do you think that is, riffing off of what Kevin just talked about?
Well, definitely. I just think that for society, doing good is no longer good enough. Mm. And so I think as you hear Ross and Kevin speak, you find that companies are setting these huge, you know, bold sustainability targets for their organizations. And so UPS has to be a part of that as a logistics company. We have to be a part of that solution. And what I will say is that as Kevin is talking about packaging, we have created a program that is called the Eco Responsible Packaging Program. And with this program, it is a way for us to recognize customers who are committed to helping the environment by using sustainable packaging. And so to participate in the Eco Responsible Packaging Program, you know, customers have to allow UPS to do an evaluation of their packaging process. And with that process, we're really looking for the company to do well in three areas. One is damage prevention, so meaning that the package contents will get there intact. Secondly is right sizing, making sure that the amount of packaging doesn't really exceed the size of the content. And then thirdly, it would be the material content. So really looking at what is making up the environmental impact of the chosen materials.
Ross, let's talk about some of the challenges you faced as a company, whether you want to talk just to startups overall, it'd be good to hear a few things on that. But even as you're on this mission to be more sustainable development, help us understand some of the challenge you faced. Again, whether it's a startup overall, a lot of people are listening to our discussion here, and or in the realm we're talking about of just being a good steward of the earth.
The thing that's made it okay for us and where we're, you know, starting to thrive again this year is just being flexible, you know, being nimble in everything that you do, and just having the options of, you know, plan at the beginning of the year, we're going to be brick and mortar. You know, we're going to partner with stores and go into retail. That's great. We were super successful at the beginning of the year. Obviously, the world turned upside down. We're like, all right, we're going to pivot back. We're going to be an online brand again. And we were able to pull those levers, move that inventory, you know, talk to our customers about what we were doing. And yeah, I think that's the same thing that we're having to do with our product roadmap. You know, we were making a lot of battery packs because people travel a lot. They go camping. They, you know, they're traveling the world. Yeah. You know, we sort of had to say, wait, are people still going to be buying battery packs if they're no longer, you know, traveling this year? Who knows when, you know, air travel is really going to come back? So we started looking at work from anywhere products. Like, what do you need if you're maybe going to be in a hybrid office where you're going in 2 days a week, but really spending more time at home working? And just thinking through sort of all of the problems that customers are facing now and reacting to it quickly, not spending too much time, you know, trying to make decisions by committee and just, you know, seeing what the problem, what the pain point is for the customer and how Nimble can really, you know, be a solution to those issues. And that's really what's guided us from the beginning.
Yeah.
What customers are asking
for. Yeah. And I think also with a lot of startups too, it's so easy to get lost and focused on what you're doing. What is the product that you're making? What is the solution to the problem that you're providing? Now that's great, because that's exactly what you should be doing. That should be your number one focus. But I think, you know, this last year really showed us all that, you know, really recommitting to beyond that solution, beyond that product, and really recommitting to your employees, to your customers, to your own community, the environment. I mean, that goes a long way. You know, it's worked for us over the last couple of years. You know, it was one thing for us to just, you know, great wireless chargers, amazing portable chargers, really protective phone cases, very fast cables. I mean, that was all great. But if we weren't giving back, if we weren't thinking about the growing e-waste problem, we weren't thinking about our packaging, if we weren't thinking about giving our employees great benefits, you know, all that stuff, it all plays into, you know, what makes a company successful this day and age, whether you're big or small.
And Kevin, I think it's so beautiful how you and Ross are so much in sync, because I've heard during this discussion that we've been having, you talk about a few things. I've heard you talk about your employees more than once, so many times, how you care for them, you're thinking about them. Heard you talk about your customers more than once, how you care about them, you're thinking about them. Heard you talk about the partnerships. So I just love this, how definitely you're living as best you can what you're talking about, because I do think sustainability is holistic. That's what I think. Thank you for taking the time to join us today. I really enjoyed hearing the story of Kevin and Ross at Nimble. Thank you so much. Really appreciated hearing Crystal's insight. Thank you all again for joining us today, and a special thank you to the team at UPS and for the opportunity to moderate this discussion. May the remainder of the year be a great success to you.